morning, everybody. It's your man, the athlete's attorney. How's everybody doing out there today? It's been a few days since I've been able to put one of these up. Matter of fact, it's been like close to a week. And I need to apologize to the viewers and the subscribers and the followers and the listeners all the way over in Jamaica and Thailand. It's checking your boy out. But first, let me give a big shout out to all of my new subscribers, Miss Natalie, Miss Amber. My man Bailey said he's going to catch up with you guys on Snapchat. Just look on the comment box section and get it. Bailey, if you're listening, come on through. But also, my man AJ, my man Francis, Devin, all of you guys, thank you for coming through. My man AMG coming through, commenting and leaving comments. Everybody that comes through and tries to help your boy out with this thing. Please remember when you come in, all you people that's just coming in, please subscribe and hit the like button. I'm begging you. I am begging you so bad. I'm begging you like Keith Sweat at a barbecue waiting on the last chicken finger. You know Keith begs. Anywho, today's subject of discussion is going to be, where is LeBron headed, and why do you not want him to go to a team why do you not want him to go to the specific team? Here are the top five choices that you have to choose from if you're on the LeBron bandwagon or you're not. Okay. Number one, they said number one would be the Lakers. Lakers are his number one destination by popular demand. Excuse me, I'm sorry. It's raining. Okay, like I said, number one choice would be the Lakers. The number two choice by many, Houston Rockets. The number three choice, Philadelphia 76ers. The number four choice, San Antonio Spurs. And the number five choice, Boston Celtics. Okay. Here is why. I'm going to go back down the list. I'm going to go back down the list and show you why San Antonio, Los Angeles Lakers, Spurs, Celtics, 76ers, why he, and Houston Rockets, I'm sorry, why he doesn't fit in some of these people's equation. We'll start with the Boston Celtics. Okay. Going over to Boston. That is going to be an absolute, in my opinion, it's just strictly my opinion, an absolute no-no. Because Boston put together a very young nucleus. Guys like Jason Tatum and all of those other guys over there. I mean, goodness gracious, the talent that they have over there, Rozier and all of those guys, that's probably going to destroy their nucleus. I mean, then you have to worry about who do I get rid of to get LeBron James, because you're going to have to get rid of somebody. You're going to have to get rid of somebody. Now, who do you get rid of? And I was telling somebody this in the barbershop yesterday. Tatum, I don't even see him being there that long in Boston, but that's besides the point. You're going to have to get rid of him and a couple more good pieces to contend with anybody for getting LeBron James. And then I don't know how Danny Ainge would even pull that off. I mean, I'm sure there are ways, but I mean, like three-team blockbuster trade deals and stuff like that. But I don't know. So I elude Boston. I excuse Boston out of the equation for simply that reason right there. Let's go with the San Antonio Spurs next. Now, we all know Greg Popovich and LeBron James have a man crush on each other. They have a man crush on each other. So, I mean, he respects the heck out of LeBron. LeBron respects the heck out of Coach Pop. And for all intents and purposes, it looks like a good fit. But here is the thing. And that's a Hall of Fame coach that LeBron's never played for. But here is the theory. My theory. San Antonio's a small market team. Very small market. I mean, the city. No, LeBron's not going to want to go to a city that doesn't have a life. You know what I'm saying? For lack of a better term, LeBron's not going to want to go to a city that doesn't have a life. I can't think of another term to use. But that's how I look at that. I mean, too small market, and a lot of the San Antonio Spurs are aging out. So, I mean, but Kawhi Leonard's still there, the second best player in the game. So I don't know, but would that be enough to keep him? And plus, the bench is not that good this year from San Antonio. You still got good pieces like Patty Mills. Danny Green's on his way. I wouldn't say he's on his way down. He's just not, haven't been himself lately. You know, so that wouldn't be enough to keep LeBron. Okay. Now let's go to the Philadelphia 76ers. Great young team. Great young stars. They got folks over there. They got my man Simmons, and we got Embiid over there. You know, J.J. Redick and a bunch of more guys over there still doing their thing. But here's the problem with that. They have all the talent in the world, but here goes the problem with that. Too many people want the ball in their hand over in Philly. Simmons is not gonna, you know, want to, you know, he's not gonna want to, you know, defer all the time, him being a ball handler, I'm sorry, him being a ball handler. So that right there, and Embiid, that's not gonna work, because the young Eagles are gonna, you know, gonna kind of force LeBron's hand. Oh, so, sort of like Kyrie did in Cleveland with him, which brings me to another point, to going back to Boston. Boston and LeBron wouldn't work because of the Kyrie thing. He can say what he wants. I've seen the interview. He can say what he wants to. Boy, he is jealous as a black girl with a white woman. That's how jealous he is. He is jealous with a black girl with a white woman. I don't know if I said that right. Put it like this. You know how jealous a black girl sees, or a black girl gets when she sees a black man with a white lady? That's how jealous Kyrie Irving would be if LeBron went over to Boston. But getting back on the 76ers, it sounds like it would work, but I just don't see it. And plus, their coaching situation and their top management situation just isn't cooking right now with the Colangelo guy getting fired or resigning or whatever. Man got fired. I don't need to. Got fired. Time I'm stepping down. Moving on. So I dismissed that one. Who else we got? We got the Houston Rockets. Seems like everybody wants them to go to the Houston Rockets and they think it would be a great fit. No. Here's why that won't work. James Harden has to have the ball in his hand, and everybody knows that he's an ISO guy. That's the new term. He's an ISO guy. Dribbling Jack. He likes to dribble. And he likes to dribble too much. James Harden has to have the ball in his hand entirely too much. How's that going to work? Chris Paul likes to dribble. Chris Paul, one of the top five greatest point guards of all time. He just moved Isaiah Thomas out of the way. So Isaiah Thomas, you ain't even in the top five best point guards of all time anymore. Mainly because you're... Never mind. But Chris Paul has to have the ball in his hand a lot. Who are you going to get rid of? You're going to get rid of Capella to get him. You're going to get rid of... You got to get rid of somebody. And it's going to be a lot of people having to be moved to get LeBron James to come over there. You have the great coach. You have Coach D'Antoni. You have him. That's a good start. But I just don't think that that's going to work because it was kind of reminds me of the Lakers when they had Shaq, Van Exel, Eddie Jones, Kobe Bryant, a whole gang more of people, Cedric Sabalas, and all of those guys. Remember that? When they had the ball and Coach Dale Harris didn't know how to do anything with that. So that won't work because it'll be somewhere in that kind of, you know, ballpark. Excuse me. All right. So, which brings me to the final team, my boys, the Los Angeles Lakers. And this is why, to me, it won't work. It's because of obvious reasons. I would definitely love to see him go to the Lakers, but right now, Magic Johnson, that's my hero, one of my all-time heroes. I don't see this working because I think LeBron wants to be like in charge of a lot of stuff. He wants to control the narrative. And, you know, that's good in a way. I mean, he can dictate who he wants on the team, but bro, it don't work, and you've proven that before with the Heat and the Cavs in the past. You've proven that before already. It don't work. So